Time now for NTV's First Alert weather forecast.
All right, welcome back here on your Wednesday. Maybe you actually can sneak outside and, you know, do something outdoors if you can get around the mud that's out there. 42, 56, and 64 in your golf cast. Maybe head over to the Cozad area. They got a nice little country club there. It will be pretty breezy, though, so keep that in mind. But as I always say, that's just a good excuse for when you maybe hit an errant shot. All right, let's talk about the pattern we're in, because we are starting to improve at least a little bit. We've got one system moving out. That's heading north today, but notice there's another one coming in already tomorrow, and there is going to be a little bit of a severe weather threat, especially southeast Nebraska down into central Kansas. But as I talked about yesterday, this ridge, it's promoting record heat in the southeast part of the country. They could be talking triple digits, but it's also impacting us because it's preventing this trough from being progressive and swinging through, which means even next week. Now, next week, I think this trough starts to weaken a bit, but it's not going to go away, which means our rain chances aren't going to completely go away next week either. Here's that risk of severe weather tomorrow. We've got a marginal risk all the way up into the Tri-Cities, a slight risk down into southeast Nebraska and central Kansas. It is something that we have to watch. Being on the cooler side of the boundary, our chances are a little bit lower here in central Nebraska, but they won't be out of the question. Viper radar shows that rain lifting northward. It will take some time, but yes, even up here to the north where you're starting off the day with showers, it will gradually come to an end as this system finally moves out. It's chilly this morning. We've got frost advisories in the southwest, and you look at the temps, upper 30s out west, mid 40s elsewhere. Skies have been clearing, so that's the good news. It is, though, breezy. West winds at 15 to 25 is that low is starting to kick out of the region. So as we look at your future cast, rainy to the north, cool elsewhere. By this afternoon, it ends up breezy but mild, at least a little bit warmer, most of us into the low to mid 60s. Another cool night on the way. There's going to be a little bit of a wind shift tomorrow. And then as we get into tomorrow afternoon, we do have to watch for some scattered thunderstorms. And actually, the best overall chance at storms could end up being late tomorrow evening into tomorrow night. 65 the high for the Tri-Cities. At least it's better than it has been. 44 tonight, tomorrow up to 64 as that chance of showers and storms returns very quickly. Upper 50s to mid 60s across the region today. And looking at your 7-day forecast, busy weekend. It's the Memorial weekend. Upper 70s Saturday and Sunday. Chances at scattered storms. Monday, Memorial Day, actually looks to be the best chance at rain. So again, if you have outdoor ceremonies planned, if you're going to be heading to the lake and you're boating, you're just outdoors on Memorial Day, you'd better stay updated with the forecast. One, because of the rain, obviously, but two, I don't think it's out of the question that we see a little bit of a severe weather threat on Memorial Day.
All right.